22. Workbench 17.1. Window to say okay. Then select Fluid Flow Fluent. We're going to use Fluent, so go to Fluid Flow Fluent. Double click. Alright. So we see the geometry, mesh, setup, all this modeler. And here let's give a name called Junction Flow. Then start geometry. Either right click, start, or double click. This is the geometry modeler. So here, this is a design modeler. Design modeler, it's called. And the first thing we do is let's change the units to inch. Units, inch. Then what we're gonna do is let's create a new YZ plane here. A new YZ plane here, which is -4 inches in the X direction. And on that new plane, we're gonna create the semicircle and close that circle. So here, first thing we do is, after we change the units to inch, click on YZ plane. Click on YZ plane. All right. Then, new plane. Move up here. This little button says new plane. So make sure you click on the YZ plane first, then new plane. All right. Then the detailed view. Let's change this transform one. Click on that and find off global X. Offset global X. Offset global X. According to our definition of 4 inches, so let's put -4. -4. Then generate. So we're going to create the semicircle on this new plane. Let's call it plane 4. Let's call it plane 4. All right, click on plane 4. New sketch. This little button says new sketch. So we're going to build our new sketch on plane 4. Click on that. It's the new sketch on plane 4. It's called sketch 1. And here, this is, instead of modeling, click on sketching. Sketching. Settings. Sketching. Settings. Let's do our usual stuff. So we click on create. Check. Check. Major 1. Minor 2. Minor tick. Right, so now we have a mesh. Then go to draw. Yep.
That was 1 and 2 for major minor. What were those numbers?
Oh, major 1, minor 2. Which means here, each grid means 1 inch. Each minor step means half. Half. All right. We're gonna create a circle with. We're doing a 2-inch pipe, 2-inch diameter pipe. So the diameter is 2 inches, radius is 1. All right, so let's do arc by center. Oh, I need to move this up maybe. Okay, arc by center, click on that. The center is the origin, and go up 1. Always clockwise. Alright, this is the arc by center. It's a semicircle. Radius is 1. So the diameter is 2 inches. Then let's close it. So line closes diameter. That's our sketch 1. It's a closed geometry. So inside, ends is fluent. When we do anything, we have the geometry must be closed. Must be closed. All right, this is our sketch 1. Next step, we're going to create the main flow or the line portion. So let's go to extrude. Under detailed view, all right, under detailed view of this extrusion, and here. The geometry, the default is sketch 1. So we're going to start, the geometry we're going to extrude is sketch 1, and we're going to do, this default is 12 inches. We have mentioned this geometry is going to extend 4 inches upstream and 8 inches downstream, so total is 12 inch, all right? So let's keep this 12 inch, then generate. So here, this is what we see. All right, this is the line portion of the geometry. Okay. Next step is let's create the branch. The branch, which is in the y direction. So let's go to. We're going to create that semicircle on xz plane. Then extrude in the y direction. So what we do is let's go to click on zx plane. Click on zx plane, and this time it is the location we're going to build the geometry. So there's no need to create a new plane. Let's just do the new sketch. ZX plane, new sketch. Now you see sketch 2. Click on sketching, settings, grid, check. Major 1, minor 2. Minor steps. Then let's go to draw. To facilitate our view, so click on Y so we can see this is the geometry. We're gonna draw this semicircle. So let's find this. Arc by center, click on that. And the center is origin. One inch radius. All right. So this is arc by center. It's 2-inch diameter circle. Then let's close the circle, semicircle. Draw the circle on this ZX plane and close the circle by connecting the diameter. All right. Let's do the extrusion again. This time, extrude. Detailed view. We're going to do this based on, based on sketch 2. So click on sketch 2. Then here on the detailed view said, click apply. All right. So it's going to extrude for based on sketch 2. And this time, this problem says in the y direction on the branch portion extends 4 inches perpendicular to the line portion. So let's extrude that 4 inches instead of 12. 4 inches. Then generate. So the geometry should look like this. This is the line portion. This is the line portion, 12 inches long, 4 inches upstream, 8 inches downstream. And this is the branch portion. The branch portion, 4 inches up. 4 inches up. All right, that's it for the geometry. That's it for geometry. So go to here, file. Let's save that. Save project. Save project. I'm going to save this on the desktop. And I'm going to call it junction. Actually, this is junction 1. See, it's very, very similar to the tutorial. It's just we have a line and a branch, and they have the same diameter, both 2 inches. All right, next, click on mesh. This is the geometry. This is the geometry in the mesh. And make sure you don't check the units. You don't check the units, just like the tutorial. Keep the default, and here the default is meter, the meter. Because later on, we're going to use the same resolution, 1E-6, 1E-. We're going to use the same values up here. The first thing we need to do is specify the name of different surface. The line portion, let's call it axis 1. So click on this, right click, create name selection. Let's call it axis 1. The top one, create name selection, exit 2. Okay. And the symmetry. Rotate, and this is where the water comes in. Click on that, create named selection. Let's call it inflow. Okay.